bless the children of thy child.
Good evening, my dear parishioners. The theme for today's service is called to lead. Whoever desires to be great among you, let him be your servant. And whoever desires to be first among you, let him be your slave. Just as the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve.
When we think of empowered leaders of the world, Pope Francis comes to mind. On several occasions since his appointment, he has refused to put himself above everyone else, demonstrating humility. According to Pope Francis, if we can develop a truly humble attitude, we can change the world.
In the current global situation, the effective leadership exhibited by women such as Finland's Sanna Marin, New Zealand's Jacinda Ardern, and Germany's Angela Merkel, among several others, are noteworthy. These leaders stand out from the rest because of their value system, which is based on empathy, compassion, listening, and collaboration.
Leadership isn't reserved for a select few, but it is a call in each of our lives. We are all invited to be leaders in different ways in our own lives. But what does true leadership look like?
We will be discomforted. First and foremost, being a leader requires us to move out of our comfort zones. It is far easier to complain about the circumstances. But if we desire real change, we must also be the ones to initiate that change, even at the cost of our own comfort.
Saying yes. Each of us are blessed with special gifts that we are invited to use to further God's work. God does not want perfect people. He wants you and me to use the talents He has given us and rely on Him for what we do not have. We are all invited to do our part in reaching out to His people, and it begins with us saying yes.
Work in community. We are designed to live and work with people. And although we may have different mindsets, we cannot get by on our own.
Like Pope Francis, who didn't shy away from asking people for their prayers, we too must follow in his footsteps, keeping our ego and pride aside, and work in collaboration with our community.
Appreciate, encourage, and help people, irrespective of who they are, as often as you can.
Remember that we rise by lifting others.
Change in attitude with a change in times, our thinking too requires change. We have to understand the need to let go of certain ideologies that we have stuck to over the years. In the current circumstances, we have to realize why we need to physically detach from the church. At the same time, we are reminded through online services that spirituality is something we carry within us and not some place we go.
Hi guys, how are you? How's hey, things?
Everything's good here.
Hi everyone, how are you all?
Good. You tell us.
I just feel sad that we're not able to meet each other and go for Mass, hear Mass together. And especially with the feast coming up, I just miss the Mass and meeting and greeting people post that.
Yeah, it's so sad. There's such a shame that we can't do all the things that we have been doing every year. But, you know, because of the situation, we have to adapt. And but we are having our feast mass online. And I hear there's going to be quite a few lovely surprises there. So, you know, that's something to look forward to.
Yeah, and we can also still celebrate and, you know, have our little socials in our buildings or in our small circles. Maybe with our families and friends or, you know, the people who live in the building. Also, online is a very good option to, like, connect with people, like, across geographies. We could just, we could talk to people across our parish or maybe, you know, even across the country or different countries. And we can use apps like Zoom, Google Meet, etc.
Yeah. And I hear that there is an online talent contest. And I just thought it's so nice. So, you know, there are some people who have a talent, but they're afraid to go on stage. So this is, you know, a nice platform where they can show their talent through this platform. And also, you know, with all this staying at home, maybe it's given them an opportunity to explore their talent a bit more.
Oh, wow. Just listening to this makes me so happy. I'm so looking forward to the new way of celebrating and sharing our joy and happiness.
Yeah, me too. Me too. What about you, Leon? Yeah.
I'm actually very intrigued to know how this is going to happen because it's the first time we're doing something like this. So I'm very excited.
Jesus gives us a practical example of what it means to be a leader. He taught us his way of servant leadership. Jesus is referred to as the king who led with a towel. He washes the feet of his followers, which was the responsibility of the house servant.
What does this mean for us? We may be called to do work that doesn't appear glamorous.
We may not be appreciated for our efforts. We have to admit that we need help.
We have to accept the situations that we are not comfortable with. We may have to put aside our wants and desires for the greater good of all.
But we are reminded, a leader is first and foremost a servant. His concern is not for himself. His concern is not to give orders, to boss other people around, to have his own way. His concern is to meet the needs of others.
Let us pray to our patroness, St. Anne's, and ask her to intercede for us as we respond to the call of leadership in our lives.
Novena in honor of St. Anne. Our Father, you were pleased to confer on Saint Anne the privilege of being the mother of the Blessed Virgin Mary, who gave birth to your only begotten Son, Jesus, the Savior of the world. Grant that we, who honor her as our heavenly patroness, may through her prayers be favored with a renewed presence of Jesus in our lives.
Ever keeping him at the center of our lives, help us to be alive to him as he speaks to us today through the scriptures, the church, and the day-to-day happenings in our lives. As a people drawn from different social backgrounds, may we never lose sight of our unity in Christ through our baptism and in the sharing of the one bread and the one cup, the Eucharist.
Bind us together as one people, generous with our time and talents in the service of all, irrespective of caste, creed, and community, particularly those who are in need, the lost, the lonely, the forgotten, the sick, the unwanted, and the aged. Thus, may we strive to build your kingdom of justice, love, and peace in our midst. We make our prayer through Jesus Christ, your Son. Amen.
Good evening, parishioners and well-wishers. Welcome to all. Let me start by saying a thank you to our parish priest, Father Laurie, and the Jesuit fathers for giving us this opportunity to come together as one St. Anne's. Thanks to our community leaders and community members for all your efforts to make this day truly spiritual. Despite the lockdown, every community brought creativity and innovation in their sharings. Truly, Anne's got talent. We began with our priests sharing on the blessings and beautiful moments of grandparents. Zone 1 called us to change our mindsets and adopt to a new normal. Zone 2 created awareness for caring for our common homes, God's creation. Zone 3 and 4 shared our outreach efforts and what it meant to walk with the excluded. Testimonies came alive of our unsung heroes and COVID warriors in and around our parish, presented by Zone 5. If you missed newsroom chats and updates, our youth use this channel to convey their mission. Not left behind, our seniors conveyed that we have churches in the parish, our homes. We've just heard the parish council sharing their experiences and commitment in the call to leadership. I am reminded of the prayer to St. Anne, bind us together as one people, generous with our time and talent in the service of all, particularly those who are in need. On behalf of St. Anne's Parish Council, I, Bernadette, would like to assure you that we are here for you and you can count on our support at all times. During the last week, we have been part of a parish community, praying and participating wholeheartedly in the sharing. If you have witnessed the seamless streaming every day at 7 p.m., there was a band of committed members who tirelessly worked on putting this together. Here, I would like to call out my PEC team, Antoinette, Pearl, Dominic, and Philip. Thank you, team, for all your support. Thanks, Irene and the media team, for all the e-posters and communications. Tomorrow, Sunday, 26 July, do join us virtually to pray together at the Feast Mass, which will be celebrated at 9:30 a.m. As we come to the close of our spiritual moment with St. Anne, our patroness, we ask for her love, intercession, and protection. Our youth have done a commendable job during the lockdown, be it towards outreach, engaging initiatives, and adopting digital expertise in driving awareness. They need our encouragement. So, let's walk with the youth this Sunday, 26 July at 6 p.m. and join in the Anne's Feast virtual celebration, requesting your presence and your words of encouragement. Let us start the celebrations tonight at 9 p.m. when the Catholic Gymkhana presents a musical night in honor of the parishes of St. Anne's at Mazagon and Bandra. This will be live on their Facebook page. Join in for an hour of music and fun. Signing off and wishing all of you good wishes for St. Anne's Feast. Bernadette de Cunha Rodrigues, Vice President, St. Anne's Parish Council, Mumbai.
Yeah.